This is Dr. Lam, founder of drlam.com. Today's questions come from somebody who has this to ask. I've never had PMS issues until I started dealing with adrenal fatigue. Why is it happening now? To understand this concept, we have to take a step back and look and understand what hormonal axis is all about. The adrenal glands are responsible for over 50 hormones of the body. Some of them are women's hormones, including estrogen and progesterone. When a person is in adrenal fatigue, there's a tendency for the body to shunt precursors such as pregnenolone to cortisol in order for the body to make these anti-inflammatory hormones. When that happens, the body can be in a state of what we call estrogen dominance. In other words, the estrogen is too much in the body relative to a progesterone because the progesterone may also be shunted away. In absolute terms, the estrogen may be normal, but in relative terms, it may be high because of the low in progesterone level. When this happens, then the body's estrogen tend to circulate and causes what we call estrogenic effect, such as bloatedness, edema, swelling of the breast, anxiety, brain fog, and severe PMS. Sometimes it's not severe, it just can be troublesome. As well, during the adrenal recovery period, sometimes the estrogenic hormone can rise, and therefore the body can experience estrogenic symptoms such as PMS and the things that we mentioned earlier as well. This usually is a temporary, and it should go away. However, if it doesn't, that means there's something else going on, such as liver congestion or extracellular matrix pollution, and underlying issues of the body has to be dealt with. Hormonal axis usually is self-regulatory, but when a person has adrenal fatigue, that regulation tend to be dysfunctional. Some people continue to have normal regulation, but many have imbalances. As a result, the estrogen can be higher than normal or lower than normal. And same thing with other hormones such as progesterone, DHEA, testosterone. So don't be too afraid. When things like this happen, talk to your practitioner. There are reasons why. We don't want to jump to the conclusion that it is only estrogen dominance that was as a result of adrenal fatigue. Sometimes these things can come on and they tend to resolve. If it don't resolve, then we have to look deeper and figure out what is really going on and what the body is trying to tell us in terms of the hormonal axis regulation. I hope you've enjoyed this video. For more information on this topic, head over to drlam.com, where I have written over 1,000 articles to help educate people. You can also call me at 626-571-1234 for more information on adrenal fatigue and how to navigate it. Finally, if you enjoy this video, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thanks for watching.